Canelo said, the Mexicans don't fuck around. Well, that's good to know, because where I'm from, we don't fuck around either.
Hey, ringsiders, what is going on? This is your host, Boxing's Objective Observer, and welcome back to Ringside Stories. Or if you're new, we cover boxing and combat sports through mini documentaries, backstories, and much more. So if you enjoy that type of content, feel free to subscribe, thumbs up, and hit that notification bell for the latest here on Ringside Stories. Thanks in advance and welcome to the channel. November 6th, i.e. Canelo vs. Plant, is upon us, and us boxing fans will find out who the first undisputed super middleweight world champion will be. Canelo Plant will answer a lot of questions, although the Canelo Plant final press conference didn't give much away.
We've gone above and beyond to prepare for this fight, and you're not going to see a better version of Caleb Plant in the ring on Saturday night.
Poner la cereza en el pastel, como decimos.
This hasn't only been a great training camp. We have witnessed a great career, and this fight is, like you would say, the cherry on top for everything.
The Canelo Plant press conference just gave a lot of the regular.
I just want to thank everybody here for, like always, to be here supporting me.
Gracias a todos los que hicieron posible esta pelea.
Thank you, everybody, for making this fight possible.
Not much time left, and really not much left to say, so I'm going to keep it short and sweet. Saturday night, make sure you tune in. You'll be seeing the first undisputed super middleweight of all time. This is history.
In my opinion, what was more interesting was what happened after that final Canelo Plant press conference, when Saul Canelo Alvarez was interviewed by former two-weight world champion and current boxing analyst Paulie Malignaggi. His conversation with the unified world champion was in Spanish, which might have been a surprise to some. More importantly, the interview Paulie Malignaggi had with Canelo was very cordial, in stark contrast with what Malignaggi had to say in years passing, specifically regarding Canelo's steroid use and his 6-month suspension before his 2018 rematch with Gennady Golovkin. So let's go back in time to scoop up a couple of clips of Paulie Malignaggi on Canelo. Shout out to IFL TV and Fight Hype.
Paulie, what is your take on this whole Canelo Golovkin situation? It seems a big mess at the moment.
I think you should probably suspend the fight for 6 months and strictly drug test Canelo the whole time. Even if he's passing a drug test now, he'll still pass clean, but he's still getting the benefits of the steroids and the PEDs that he was taking. So I think if you delay the fight 6-7 months, maybe make it like December, and strictly drug test him the whole time. I mean strict. That way you let the stuff clear his system and maybe you can get less benefit from it. I mean, then you can have the fight. And I don't see a problem with that. But if you're going to put up these suspensions just to save face, because that's all to me that this is. I think if you fight May 5th, this whole suspension is just a save face suspension. Just God forbid Golovkin gets seriously hurt or killed in the fight. Then you have a situation where this guy, the government, they're looking at him and be like, this guy failed a steroid test and you let him fight? You still let him fight? Like, people go to jail for that, you know what I'm saying? So let alone getting sued. So I think this is just a saving face kind of situation where if they let him fight, oh, but we suspended him, so we did something. I think you can't let him fight. I don't think there's any way you can let him fight at this point, you know what I'm saying?
Do you believe the story about the contaminated meat?
Fuck no, I don't believe it. What am I, retarded? Come on, man. Yeah, it's somebody else that don't ask me that. Well, yeah, don't bullshit me, man. You know what I mean? Like I said, if you wait, make them wait it out 6-7 months and then give the fight under the right circumstances, under the correct way to do things. But maybe I'm being influenced by the media. I don't know. Every headline I look at, you know, people are saying, oh, this fight may really get canceled. So maybe I'm being influenced by the media. I'm starting to think maybe the Vegas Commission is going to do the right thing. We'll see. And it's really a painful situation for, you know, Canelo's team and Golden Boy, and also Golovkin's team and Loeffler.
They're in an awkward position here, the Golovkin and his team, Tom Loeffler. Golovkin's team are in an awkward position here with this as well, aren't they?
Yeah, but they still lose out on the money.
Yeah, that's what I mean, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, it's like I'm talking between a rock and a hard place, you know? Hopefully you can reschedule the fight for, like, December. That's my hope. Because, you know, boxing wants to see it, and everybody wants to see it. So hopefully you can reschedule the fight by December. And go from there.
Listen, if you give a 6-month suspension, okay, with no fine and no consistent drug testing after that, what's the fucking point? The guy can just go home right now and dope. He could be doping up right now for all we know. He's suspended. He's not getting tested. He's not doing anything. Okay, the way you handle that, if you want to give a 6-month suspension and let it play out, you fine him. You give a 6-month suspension, and then you put him on a 2-year probationary period where he's consistent. consistently and strongly random drug tested throughout the next 2 years. And if he fails any of those tests in the next 2 years, you add 2 or 3 years to that suspension. So then it becomes a 2.5 year suspension. But you know why they won't do that? Because they don't want to actually catch Canelo's cheating. Because if, God forbid, you catch this guy cheating again and you got to spend them for 2-3 years, then you all lose money and it's a big problem. So nobody actually wants to fix
a testing in Mexico.
Yes, that would be. That's why he missed time the cycle.
Surprise!
He missed time the cycle. He didn't expect them to show up in Mexico. You know what I mean? He didn't expect them to come show up in Mexico. So he thought like, okay, I'm gonna get to Vegas. By this point, it's gonna clear my system. Nah, my man, we came and surprised you. But I'll tell you what, that's about the time you start testing for a May 5th fight. Is early September, early February, right? So this guy was doing it during his time off, which is the problem in general for if you don't have year-round random drug testing. These guys are gonna do it during their time off consistently. So part of this suspension problem should be 6 month suspension, 2 year probationary period where you're drug tested all the time, consistently, randomly, consistently for the next 2 years. And if you fail that one, you get a 2 year suspension. They're not gonna do it though. They don't have the balls to do that. You can need balls to do that.
No jail time?
Huh?
No jail time? 30 days in jail for?
Nah, no jail time. Just give him the, force him a drug test. That's like jail for him. If you force him a drug test like that, that's like jail.
Now I understand Paulie Malignaggi currently is a boxing pundit, so he's probably doing some work, and it's fight week for one of the biggest fight of 2021, that being Canelo Alvarez versus Caleb Plant. I just thought it was funny to see the magic man, who has never been at a loss for words even after his active boxing career, being very cordial with Canelo Alvarez. In that sense, Caleb Plant at least confronted Canelo on this subject during the first Canelo versus Plant press conference.
And you a drug cheat. And you a drug cheat. So tell me something. Tell me something. Oscar Valdez can pop positive for something and not get suspended for 6 months, but he can pop positive for something and get suspended
for 6 months.
Don't make
excuses.
But somehow
don't make excuses before the fight.
You're a cheater.
Don't make excuses before the fight.
You got suspended for 6 months. You're a cheater.
That's whatever you say.
Fuck you.
See you November 6th.
Suck my dick.
You want to see something special on you. And feel.
Now I'm sure Paulie Malignaggi is as much a boxing fan as anyone else. And as a boxing analyst, I think Malignaggi is one of the best out there when it comes to breaking down fights eloquently. I think Paulie Malignaggi makes interesting observations, effortlessly swinging from the fan's point of view to the fighter's point of view, as he possesses vast knowledge about the sports, the business, and the total perception of boxing.
I think it's the slickness of Caleb. Can he maneuver around the firepower of Canelo? Canelo has, you know, it's not just firepower, he's got some boxing ability, but I think Caleb's fast feet are a key for him, especially early on, in order to bank some rounds. But of course, banking some rounds is not always going to be easy, because you have to fight off that early anxiety of being in such a big fight that you've never been in before. And so if that anxiety gets the best of you, you're kind of a little tight. And I felt like Billy Joe Saunders in that fight, in his fight with Canelo, was a bit tight and couldn't be as slick as he wanted to be early in that fight, and couldn't get off the kind of shots he needed to get off early in that kind of fight when he was fresh. So, you know, you're dealing with a lot of variables, a lot of intangibles when it comes to fighting Canelo Alvarez. But the overall style matchup is basically the slickness of Caleb against the firepower of Canelo.
What is the route, you know, say if you was at the same weight category as Canelo, Paulie, how would you approach a fight against him?
I mean, you try to approach it by fighting it at the proper distance. You know, he's got so much firepower, you want to keep him on the outside. And not that Canelo can't hit you on the outside, he's got some sneaky shots, but Canelo doesn't put a lot of combinations together. It's more, you know, ones and twos that come in, you know, maybe an overhand right, left hook to the body. You know, he sets up that left hook to the body by throwing the overhand right. He doesn't put more than two, maximum three together, really. So, you know, you can keep him from getting off with your jab and, you know, good feet and pot shots. And, you know, sometimes you got to stick him with some hard shots. But again, it's easier said than done, you know, because, you know, you're dealing with all, you're doing all that, but you're also dealing with a guy who's going to be trying to hit you back all the while, you know. And so, like Canelo said it in the Grand Arrival, somebody asked him about the style. He said, yeah, he's a jabber, he's got good qualities, nothing I haven't seen before. You know, let's face it, Caleb is not going to be the first guy to try to jab at Canelo, right? So we'll see. We'll see how it plays out. We have seen Canelo troubled at times with certain kind of jabs and jabbers. But ultimately, Canelo has found a way to get the job done each time. So we'll see Saturday night if how it plays out.
But anyway, Canelo Alvarez versus Caleb Plant is upon us, and we're going to see, hopefully, the first ever undisputed super middleweight world champion. These are just my observations. What are yours? Let us know in the comments below. If you like more content like this and you haven't, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, give a thumbs up, and hit that notification bell. It helps out the channel a lot, i.e. inspire us to make more quality content for y'all. As always, thank you so much for your support, and welcome to Ringside Stories. Now, if you've done that already, you're amazing. We already know that you are the true undisputed world champion. Till next time, ringsiders, this is your host, Boxing's Objective Observer, with Ringside Stories. Thanks for watching, and have a legendary day.